It's Jesse Lozano, JoJo on the radio. We're back here with Kiss FM, sold out Jingle Ball, presented by Capital One in the Mercedes-Benz Interview Lounge.
Wow.
BB Rexha.
Wow, that's really good.
BB, how are you?
I wanted to get there.
I'm great.
BB, why are you making fun of my outfit? Because, you know, I didn't,
I didn't make fun of your outfit, JoJo. I just said I feel like he put so much more effort into his outfit.
What's wrong with a black t-shirt
like I wore
in January, February, March,
April? Jingle Ball! We're at Jingle Ball!
This is like your favorite holiday party.
Yeah,
like, it
is
like that.
Of course.
Okay, well, I'm
you know
sorry,
what?
BB.
It's okay. We accept you the way that you are, right?
You know what? Actually, we're fine with it.
Okay,
we love you.
Fair enough. Hey, BB, before we get to anything else, I saw you tweeted, and I'm not sure if this is still something you're searching for. I want to find someone who can eat good food with, laugh, and someone who is really good at making out. Have you found that person
yet?
Yeah,
that's what I said. What's wrong with that? That's the truth.
Nothing wrong with that.
You gotta find a Latino.
Look. Oh, really? You think
the
so?
The makeout, if the makeout part is important to you,
no, you
gotta find a Latino.
You know what's important to me? Like, doing nothing and having a good time.
So, if they make out terribly.
No.
Okay.
Okay, pause.
I mean, you can always teach somebody that. You can't
okay.
teach somebody
you're
a
right, that's coachable.
Right?
You can't teach someone to be able to enjoy Netflix on the couch with you and have a good
yeah,
time.
Yeah, or like, my favorite thing is, as I said, I love scratch-offs, lottery scratch-offs. Going to the gas station and just buying lottery scratch-offs.
Really?
Yeah, it's fun.
Does she know what we got her for Christmas?
We might have a little something
for
you.
I got it.
Oh, you did.
I lost, okay?
Good Lord.
I'm very bummed about that.
Hey, let me ask you a quick question. I was a huge Big Brother fan over the summer, literally an obsessed fan with that show. And I'm sitting there, and all of a sudden there are these three people, JoJo. They're living in this house. There's like three or four of them left. They get a surprise live concert from BB Rexha. It was literally an audience of what, four people or something
three.
Like that? Three.
Oh, no, four. Sorry, you're right. Four.
So is that a better performance? Do they get a little something extra from BB, or does that make you more nervous to not perform in front of a big crowd like that?
It makes me, I don't know, I guess I'm nervous. I don't know. I think it's like, what?
I would think that a big crowd, gigantic crowd, you don't really see anybody,
yeah,
but
so
you make eye contact.
You just do it. But like when you have four people in a room, yeah, you can really read if they're like liking it or not.
And they don't get to, they're like sequestered, JoJo. They don't get anything.
Yeah.
So she
house,
was like.
That house was, it wasn't that stinky, but it was pretty
little
stinky.
Funky, a little funky,
right?
Yeah, it was a
funky house.
Goodness.
But they can't listen to music, anything. It must have been like an angel.
Oh, they like gave
me
a whole like thing. They were like, you cannot talk about like who Cardi B is. You cannot tell them anything. Like they had no idea. Like they, I don't think they know. They
anything,
knew anything
happening in the world.
They didn't know about everybody getting engaged, like Ariana and Hailey. And
wow.
I was like dying. Like I wanted to just tell everything.
But funny?
I signed a contract, so.
Yeah.
Well, BB Rex is hanging out. BB, this has been a pretty good year for you.
Yes.
Walk
I mean,
me
like,
through this year. This is just
come on,
give me
JoJo.
Some highlights.
I've always wanted to perform at Jingle Ball. I used to go to Jingle Ball all the time. And like I'm finally here. Like I'm performing at Jingle Ball. That's awesome.
What was the first thing you wanted to check out behind the scenes once you like got here? You got your access pass and you've been here before.
I just like to see like who's near me in the dressing rooms.
Yeah. Who's near
like,
who's
who I'm next to Sean. So we already said hi.
Oh,
I love Sean. So you know, I do the occasional like if the door's open, I'm like nosy. I like
so
like,
you're the peeker.
Oh.
I thought G-Eazy was the peeker.
Oh, he's a peeker big time.
Oh, but you are the peeker too.
Yes, I
okay.
am.
All right.
Why not? It's fun.
You could give us the backstage scoop.
Oh, I can give you everything.
Give me something else you've seen backstage.
Oh no.
A little dishage, you know,
or smell.
Oh.
Not sure what that means, but
I've
I'm not.
I've met some smelly people. Some bad breath. I'm just joking.
All right, I get it.
Hey, Christmas. What are we doing?
I'm going home, back to New York, and I want to just cuddle my dog.
Aw.
I'm gonna cuddle my dog, and I just want to eat a lot.
Is this the dog you brought to the studio the one night?
Yeah. She's in New York right now, yeah.
And she, if I recall correctly, your dog likes to chew iPhone cords, right?
Yes, and she eats. Oh my gosh, you have such a good memory.
I do, right?
She chews every single iPhone cord. It's the weirdest thing.
Like, not any
pretty
cord.
Standard just, for a dog. I got a dog that does the same exact thing.
No, but specifically iPhone cords.
Like
it's got to be an iPhone.
Also, if you switched your phone to a Samsung, it may be a little different story.
Yeah, maybe, but like she loves iPhone cords, so I don't know.
All right, I have one question to ask you. This is from my wife. We're going to Vegas next week because Florida Georgia Line has a residency. And she just wants to know if you're going to happen to be in Vegas for whatever reason. And then you'll just like show up on stage just for a quick.
When is that?
Next Friday.
I will not.
Oh,
but
darn it. Okay.
I'm
well,
sorry.
At least I found out.
I'm sorry.
There's a chance, right? People go to Vegas enough.
Well,
there's
yeah.
a chance.
I mean, I don't know. It depends on like if I'm in the area and stuff like that. And I know that I'm doing the whole Jingle Ball. I said ball.
Wall.
The whole Jingle Ball run. So, like, I have to, you know.
You got to do your thing.
Do my duties. But if I probably will maybe pop up some of the shows.
Do you do that? Because that song you guys have, it's
yeah.
like the best song ever.
Of course. Why not? It's fun.
Why not?
If I'm in the mood.
Hey, musically speaking, catch me up. What do we got coming up? What's on
2019. I have a new single coming out.
Hey.
I'm so excited. But that's a secret.
Can't say anything.
No, I can't. I really can't.
You want to hum it without saying the words?
I'm just joking.
Sneak peek right there. BB, thank you.
I'm all on. Oh, man.
No, that's not. It's really, it's a lot.
I'm just trying to figure it out. It's like a something.
Okay, the festive people stand here. The unfestive people stand on the other
side.
Yeah,
we're over here festive. We're part of the holiday
party. I'm
going to
stand over here.
Anybody Merry else? Christmas.
Is anyone wearing a black t-shirt?
No, he doesn't match us.
Fine,
he's Scrooge.
Bah humbug. There's nothing wrong with my black t-shirt. It's fine, BB.
All right, gotta work on that.
If you're following us on Instagram, you'll know exactly what BB Rex is talking about at 1027 Kiss FM.